Okay, so I've got this thing about dialed in. I am so happy that I made this model, because this is just solving everything for me, all the problems. So I've got my bracket here, and I got my holes tapped in here. So I actually took, so you can see here, I've got, this is my actual stock right here, that line. This line represents the edge of the tubing where this is going to, grab onto. Well, it's going to be like this, but only in this orientation. The hole is blocked by my template here. And so I just transferred my lines. So this line here is the bolt line, which is that line. Put a mark right here, put it here, then drew my bolt holes here, and then transferred this to this. So now I'm going to have some slotted adjustment. These are 3/8 inch hardened bolts, and I'm going to have some adjustment laterally, side to side, to get the pulleys exactly in line with together. So now I feel confident that I can just go ahead and weld this to my piece that has the circle on it, and I'll get that welded up, and then I just have to weld two angle supports. I probably don't even have to do that, as stout as the steel is, but I'm going to. So let me get that done right now. Okay, look at this subtle thing here that I didn't recognize until I actually hung the motor on the machine for the first time, my new motor with my bracket. You can see the way this bracket is slightly cocked this way. So that's to compensate for the way the whole block, the bearing block, is mounted in the bandsaw. And I just didn't notice this, where you can see that it's, probably about 3 degrees or 4 degrees. And off the, if you extended a center line here, you can see that it's cocked that way. So when I put my motor on, I just had the two slots, and I thought that I was, I thought, oh, I'm just going to have this thing hanging exactly parallel to that piece of tubing, and it's going to line, the center line's going to line up just perfect with the motor. Well, that's not the case. So I have to make an adjustment on my bracket, so I have some camber adjustment, so I can cock my thing to get the right camber to make sure that the center line is running parallel with the center line of the pulley on the bandsaw. So I got to just drill some more holes in my bracket. It's not a big deal. The hassle is, since I have this thing welded together, I can't really get it on the drill press in this manner like this, because this will be in the way. So I have to flip it over, and in order to flip it over, I've got to make an adjustment on my cast iron bandsaw table support. And you remember I made this during my welding for woodworker series, and this thing is just awesome. These four posts telescope up and down, and then these dial it in. So when I do this, it doesn't matter how much weight I put on this, I'm not flexing this, my table out here, which is always a real drawback of bandsaw or drill presses. They just have that single column mount here. So I'm just going to lower this down. You'll see, this is the first time I've done it in a couple months where I've actually had to adjust. This is kind of my perfect setup that I do almost all my drilling right at this thing. But I'm going to show you how easy it is to lower the whole unit down and get this setup going. Okay, so let's lower this down. You'll see how easy it is. I'm really proud of this design that I came up with here. And I'm really happy that the time I put into it was really rewarded with such a functional thing that just makes my life better. When I have this thing up and supported, it just seems like my drill press has much more power, because everything is, I'm not giving away any flex in the tabletop when I'm doing heavy drilling. Because I've got the screw here, so now you can see that I'm under complete control as I draw the mechanism down. And I'll see if I've got enough room if I lower this. If I don't, when I actually lower the table down here, I'll see if I've got enough room. If I don't, I'll raise it up and I'll just take these guys off, and that'll give me another 4 inches. And if worst comes to worst, if I have to, 4 bolts will slide the whole unit out. I thought I did a real good demo of how you weld a nut really, really accurate onto the end of a piece of pipe to make sure that the nut is oriented so the center line of the screw is just perfect, because this is something you can make all kinds of things out of for your shop if you can weld a nut on an end of a piece of pipe as a threaded receiver. But if you get that nut on there cocked, it's trouble. So you may want to check that out in my Welding for Woodworkers series. Super simple. It'll make perfect sense once you see it done. You can see, look at this. See, without my supports here, you can see that even this big drill press, how it flexes, and I'm not putting that much weight on it, you know? So this thing is incredible for a drill press like this. Just gives every, you know, 4-point solid contact, you know, to keep from flexing that cast iron. Okay, well, again, here's where a drill press with these slots, you know, in the table where you can lock the, you know, those T-nuts in there. This is where a drill press like this pays for itself every single day. So there's my set of step clamps. And you can see I've got a couple of them nutted together with a connecting nut. And now I've got the, you know, this where I can, after I get it marked and get my holes peened, I can just come up here and I can make really, really accurate square drill holes. And I checked everything that when I do tighten it down, I am pulling it really nice square. So even though I've got this crazy setup here, and I wish I didn't have to do this, but like I said, I didn't foresee this being a necessity. But you know, that's what woodworking, steel fabrication is all about, is just being flexible and making corrections and changes on the fly and working with what you have. So just a scrap of hard maple, you know, drill the same distance as those slots, and I've got a really nice rigid clamp here that I can pin that thing down and hold it perfectly square. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and drill those and do my tapping and stuff. I've already shown enough of that, so you'll know what I'm doing. I'm just drilling and tapping and just getting on with it.